My name is Megan Jensen, and these are the basics of accounting. So we'll start with the fundamental accounting equation, which is the assets equals liabilities plus owner's equity. Within the fundamental accounting equation, we do have a double entry system, which is every time a transaction takes place within your business, you have two offsetting sides with debits and credits. An asset has a normal debit balance, which means that if you debit an asset, it will increase that account. A liability has a normal credit balance, which means if you credit that account, it will increase it, and a debit will decrease it. Owner's equity accounts generally have a normal credit balance. And within the owner's equity accounts, we have revenues and expenses. And revenues have the normal credit balance, which will increase owner's equity overall. And expenses have a normal debit balance, which will decrease owner's equity while also increasing expenses. It's kind of weird. So an asset is a property of value owned by a business. There are different types of assets that we have within our balance sheet. A current asset refers to cash and other items that can be turned back into cash within a year. Cash is the biggest asset that most businesses have, which includes funds in checking and savings accounts. We also have accounts receivable, which are amounts due from customers to your business. We also have a notes receivable, which are promissory notes by customers to pay definite amounts plus an interest by a certain date. We have inventories, which are raw materials and merchandise on hand. There are prepaid expenses, which are supplies on hand and services paid for but not yet used. A common prepaid expense is insurance. We also have long-term assets, which are tangible assets that are used in the business, such as buildings and land and equipment and other large items. Intangible assets, on the other hand, refer to assets that cannot physically be held, but are valuable because they can be licensed or sold outright to another company. And examples of those are like copyrights, patents, goodwill, and trademarks. Next in our fundamental accounting equation, we have liabilities, which are legal obligations to a business to pay a debt. Current liabilities are due within a relatively short period of time, within a year usually. Current liabilities include accounts payable, which are accounts that you have to pay directly to another company. Notes payable are similar to accounts payable, except there's an interest rate that goes along with it. And then we also have accrued expenses such as salaries and wages payable, other things like that that have been accrued up to a certain point but you haven't paid them yet. Long-term liabilities are obligations that will not become due for a long period of time, which is generally over that 1 year mark. Examples of those are bonds payable, mortgage note payable, and other debts that don't have to be paid for more than a year. Owner's equity, which is also known as net worth, it's what would be left over if you paid off everyone the company owes money to. So if you wanted to switch around the fundamental accounting equations, it would be assets minus liabilities equals owner's equity. Next we have the income statement, which is used to figure out what your net income or loss would be for the accounting period. And that is used to, the way we calculate that is revenues minus expenses equals net income or loss. And we have an example of one right up here for the Paul Guitar Shop. It's used to inform investors and potential investors of net income or loss for that accounting period. And lastly, we have the balance sheet, which is a snapshot of a company's financial standing. And this is one way to really show the fundamental accounting equation, because on this side, we have the assets, and those have to equal to the liabilities and the owner's equity. And that's all I have for you. You guys have any questions?